time, you will know what it's like to lose. To feel so desperately that you're right, yet to fail all the same. Dread it. Run from it. Destiny still arrives. Fun isn't something one considers when balancing the universe. But this does put a smile on my face.
I know it was a little indulgent. I know. Thank you for all for watching that. If you guys watched it and didn't just scroll through it, although I cannot blame you if you just scrolled through it. I know I got a little indulgent there, but I can't help it. I love Thanos. I think Thanos is a cool villain. I love the villains anyway. You know, villains are usually a little more exciting than the heroes because, you know, I find myself siding with Thanos because I would love to snap my fingers and get rid of half the assholes I work with, but that's another story. But anyway, friendly reminder, physique reveal slash update, because it's a, you know, it's a continuing process. So June 22nd, I turn 40. Come watch me embarrass myself on the internet. Anyway, so it's June here in good old SoCal. It's the start of summertime. It's getting warm, you know, breaking out the shorts. Having a good time out there, you know, water sports and, you know, everything that SoCal is famous for. So I want to talk a little bit about something a little different today. So, like I said, it's June here in SoCal, and June, for the Jones family at least, is a little, it's a little weird for us. It's where it starts to come into a little something that we like to call, that my wife has dubbed, the trifecta. In the Jones house. And let me tell you a little bit about what the trifecta is. The trifecta, basically, there is a whole bunch of stuff that happens all within a month, you know, of each other when June rolls around. I mean, it's already been a very busy month. My son just graduated from high school, you know, he turned 18, graduated from high school, you know, everybody's, you know, it's a crazy time, man. It's a crazy thing to have a kid that graduated from high school. I have three children, the oldest of which is 18, like I told you, and then the other two are, they're super young, they're 5 and 6, they're actually about 10 months apart. That's a whole other story right there. But anyway, they're all in the same kind of few month, actually weeks time span. But the trifecta, like my wife calls it, is three particular things, hence trifecta. It's Father's Day, my birthday, and our anniversary are all within not even a month. It's like maybe a week and a half, maybe 2 weeks of each other. They're super, super close. So my wife likes to call it the trifecta because we get, you know, we get three things all at the same time. Now, what I would like and what I didn't understand as a child, and I definitely understand now, you know, is this thing about dad guilt that I want to get into, you know. And I'll tell you what I'm talking about. Those of you who have children and who have a family, you guys will understand what I'm talking about. And the rest of you, well, you might have to learn something tonight. But anyway, so like I said, it's Father's Day, my birthday, and our anniversary all within 2 weeks of each other. So as a dad, as a father or parent, what I would prefer is that we all just have one big thing. You know, let's just have one to do, or at least for my birthday and for Father's Day. Because, you know, as a father, you know, I've been a dad for a long time. My oldest son is 18. You know, I've been a dad for a minute, and, you know, it's stressful, man. I mean, moms have, easily the hardest job. At least my wife does. She's got the hardest job of anybody in the house because she's got to keep track of everybody, including me. It would be one thing if I had my head screwed on straight and I could keep shit together. I can't even do that for myself. My wife, I don't know where my car keys are right now, and I'm at work. But I know I could call my wife right now and be like, "Hey, baby, do you know where my car keys are? Oh, have you checked your right next to the hard drive on your computer?" And there they are. See? My wife knows everything. She has to keep us all in line. So mom has definitely the hardest job. So as a dad, you're always trying to mitigate that. Or as a husband in this case, you're always trying to mitigate that. You don't want your wife to get stressed out. You want to make sure everybody knows, you know, how hard she works. And you want to make sure she gets the credit she deserves. So I always feel a little guilty taking anything away from that. I understand Father's Day. People want to show their support. They want to show that they care. And as a dad, how I feel about Father's Day is everybody take the day off. That's what I would do if you asked me what I wanted for Father's Day. Everybody take the day off. Everybody take five. You know what? You know what? Go do what you all want to do. For my 5 and 6 year for my 6 year old, watch Moana as many times as you want. Go for it. For my 5 year old, go down the slide as many times as you want. For my 18 year old, go with your buddies to the movies. Watch 3 movies if you want to. Or stay at home, watch the MCU timeline from start to finish. Go for it. My wife, go get a massage, go get a pedicure, go get some sushi, enjoy your day. That's what I would ask for if they asked me what I wanted for Father's Day. I don't need no presents. I don't need no tie. I don't need none of that stuff. I want everybody to just chill. Take a day off on Dad. That's what I would want for Father's Day. My birthday, you know, I've never been big on my birthday because, you know, I've always seen how hard people have to work to try to make it special. And it's so sweet and kind. And for me, it's just, you know, because I don't really want anything, you know. There's nothing that I, you know, my wife is always asking me, "Baby, what do you want for your birthday? What do you want? Your birthday's coming up. What do you want?" I'm at that point in my life where I don't really have any material stuff. I mean, there's always something that I want, but nothing that, you know, is, I mean, I would be something, it would be something that I'm like excited about for a few minutes, and then it would be just kind of, you know, oh, okay, well, now it just sits on a shelf. You know, it's, I went through a point where I was going through rings. Like I wanted, like I used to have a ring for every finger. I used to be a ring guy, you know, and I would have my ring collection and my ring box set and everything, and it was looking really good and really put together. And then after a while, it just didn't mean that much anymore, you know, and now I have like 50 rings and they're all sitting in a box on top of my dresser, and it's like I wear them every once in a while when I'm just dressing up, but that's not that often because we work all the time. So so the trifecta, it's great, but the only thing I really look forward to is our anniversary, because our anniversary is about us and not about just me for Father's Day or just me on my birthday. But that's the trifecta. The trifecta has expanded to way more stuff. I mean, just in June, we got my son's graduation. My youngest son's birthday is in June, then my birthday, and then everything. And then, you know, it's just, it's become like a quintet now. There's so much stuff going on. Plus, we're planning our vacation for our anniversary in August. You know, I mean, our anniversary is in July, but we're going to do something in August. But, you know, so. And every time, because my wife is the sweetest, I can't say this enough, I can't. And I'm not saying it because baby, I know you're watching right now. I'm not saying this to get a hoot and a holler from you. I'm saying it because it's true. I can't stress enough how sweet and thoughtful and kind my wife is. I mean, my wife will go, I mean, I don't want to tell this story just yet, but my wife, you know, you like, she's in my brain, man. She knows stuff and she figures out stuff and she's able to put stuff together and she does the most thoughtful things and she is the sweetest lady. She just wants everybody to have a good time. She's the best host. Whenever people come over to the house, she always makes sure everybody has a good time. If you're a friend of my wife and she knows you like Corona, we don't drink Corona in the house, but she'll have a case of Corona because she knows one person out of 50 who come over for a party like it. So there it is. You know, she's just that kind of lady. So she wants to make sure everybody feels appreciated and everybody feels good. But I get dad guilt. Like, you know, I feel bad, doing anything for myself, you know? I mean, like, you know, I'm starting to get into tattoos more often, you know? I mean, tattoos are fucking expensive, man. Holy fuck. The one I got right now is over $1,000, and I'm looking at more that are even more than that. So, you know, it just doesn't seem right. Like, every time I go to buy myself something, it feels like I should be spending this money on something else. Like, I should be getting something for the kids. The kids probably need clothes or shoes or, you know, we probably need groceries, you know, and I'm going out here spending $100 on a pair of gym shoes that I don't need because I already got four pair, but I don't have one in blue. You know, this, there's always something stopping me from doing something for myself, which is why right now I only have one. I have one pair of shoes that I don't use in the gym. I have one pair of jeans, you know, and I have a bunch of t-shirts because I'm a t-shirt fanatic, you know, but I don't feel right buying something for myself because I know the kids probably need something. The kids always need stuff. You know, if you have small kids, you know, you roll around in sand and they're, you know, they're falling off their bikes and scraping their knees and all kinds of shit. They always need something. It's a zero-sum game, man. You're never going to get ahead of it. You know, I don't know how kids tear up underwear. Do your kids tear up their underwear? How the fuck does that happen? My kids have holes in their underwear, man. What the hell? They got Paw Patrol underwear with little holes in them. How does that even happen? You know? So, I don't know. Kids always need something, man. So, it's almost like you almost have to let yourself off the hook just to have a good time. That's why it's easier, because we're getting older now. I'm about to turn 40, my wife. You know, we're getting older, and all we want is just to spend time with each other, which is, you know, the commodity that you never get back. You never get your time back. So, we're trying to spend as much time together as we can, because, you know, before the kids eviscerate us. So, you know, I can't feel good about doing something that's just for me. Like this tattoo that I really want, you know? I mean, that's something that is just for me. Nobody can even use it. If I buy a car, you know, that's something that everybody can use. I have an 18-year-old who's learning how to drive. The kids always got appointments and things and park and parties and everything, and they're always going someplace. That's a car is something that everybody in the house can use. A tattoo or a shirt or a suit or an expensive pair of shoes, that's something that only I can use. And that just never feels right. And if you're a dad or a husband, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Those of you who have kids know what I'm talking about. And if you don't have the dad guilt, well, maybe you're just better off than me and you have the money that you can afford it. Or maybe you don't have the vices that I have, you know? I don't know. But it just doesn't get any easier, man. It doesn't get easier from year to year. You know, kids are going to start getting older. These kids will not stop eating, man. I swear to God. You know, we started going to Costco this year. You know, I put off going to Costco as long as I could, because by the last time we went to Costco as a family when I was growing up, I was probably 20 years old. And I was old enough to start looking around and saying, good God, this is a cavernous warehouse store full of neutered adults. This is just fucking sad. And I'm just, you're seeing guys in Costco, grown men with their wives walking through Costco, shuffling through that fucking cavernous store, just, you know, dead inside. I was excited about going to Costco. Oh, I can go to Costco as an adult. But goddamn, man, it's like walking through, it's terrible, man. Just watching those grown men just looking for their balls, man. It's absolutely horrifying. So, but yeah, I got the dad guilt, man. I got the dad guilt about a lot of things, man. I'm a good dad. I'm not a great dad. I'm a good dad, but I'm a terrible parent. I'm a horrible parent, and everybody knows it. Everybody in my neighborhood knows it. I'm that guy at the end of the block who stay away. That's old man Jones' house. You know, I'm a good dad. Here's the difference. So, like, I'm a good dad in the fact that I do what I'm supposed to do. I have the basic dad package. I make sure the rent gets knocked out. There's gas in the car. There's food in the fridge. I make sure that nobody dies. That is the basic dad package. If you're on duty as a dad, which is 24 hours a day, if you're on duty as a dad and one of your kids dies or gets lost or gets hit by a car, you fucked up. You lost the dad game. Okay, so I'm a good dad in the sense that I do what I'm supposed to do, and 98% of what you're supposed to do is make sure everybody has what they need. Everybody has clothes, shoes, food, a roof over their head. Nobody's sleeping outside in the rain unless that's your, you know, unless that's what you're doing as like a discipline thing, but I don't think we're there yet. But anyway, we are, you know, I'm give myself maybe a 78%, maybe an 8. I'll say 80. 80% as a dad, I'm good, but I'm a terrible parent. I'm a terrible parent. This has just happened a couple of days ago. So my son, my youngest son, he's 5 years old. He's going to be 6 this month. And all he wants, I'm an old school dad. So my kids are growing up in that old school way. And my kids like old school shit. They like going outside to play and just run around. They got bikes. They got scooters. They got all kinds of stuff. And they want to just go outside, hang out with friends, play in the dirt, dig a hole, go down the slide, do the swing set. Kid shit, okay? I'm a child of the 80s, you know? I was a latchkey kid. You know, that's all we had was each other, you know? We didn't have a lot of stuff. My parents were blue collar. We didn't have a whole lot of stuff. I mean, we still had stuff, but we grew up in a time where you go outside and you play. So that's what my kids do. They go outside and they play. You know, they still have times where they have their little iPads and I let them play on my phone. Yeah, you know, the technology works its way in, but we're still old school parents. So, you know, the other day we're outside and my kid's 5 and he doesn't have the best situational awareness yet. I mean, he's 5. He's a kid, you know, so I'm not going to let him go out there and run the streets by himself. So what we'll do is we have what's called play street. So we'll basically just open the garage and he goes outside. He's got his bike, his scooter, his big wheel. He's got all this stuff there. And you know, just go outside and just go play. Other little neighborhood kids come around. Now, here's where we run into a problem, because these neighborhood kids are little shitheads. Not all of them, but some of them. You know, these little kids, they got little fucking mouths, man. And I'm just not, like I said, I'm old school, man. My kids got the two worst possible parents because we are both old school. Not only are we old school, but we are both the alphas in our litter, okay? Me and my wife are both the oldest siblings in our tribe, respectively, okay? So we were always the ones who had to follow the rule. If you're the oldest child in your home, then you know what I'm talking about. You had to be the one to follow the rules because you were the one that your parents were worried about fucking up. So we had to follow the rules. We didn't have a choice. We had to follow the rules. We had to be the example. You know, 2, 3, and 4 down the line, they let those kids juggle knives. And like, because you, if you're the oldest child, you find yourself saying that all the time. Like, how come he gets to get away with that shit all the time? Well, so these little kids come around and they just, you know, I let them, you know, come in and play. And, you know, like I said, my son's got a couple little things he could play with, big wheel, scooter, bike. So they trade, you know, not all the kids have one. I think one kid comes with a scooter, he rides the bike. They trade up, you know, they have a good time. And this one kid from next door, actually, I'm talking to my kid. I tell him, hey, listen, buddy, it's time to go inside. And he's at that age where he's testing his parameters. He's testing his boundaries. How much shit can I get away with before I get my face slapped? So I say, look, buddy, it's time to go inside. It's getting late. And he says, no, I don't want to go in. And I just look at him like he's crazy. Like, excuse me? What'd you just say to me? Now, this is between me and my kid. Now, this other kid from next door, he doesn't want to go in either. I don't think he even has parents. I've never seen his parents. They never come out. They never monitor this kid. This kid is probably a little younger than mine. He's got to be like 4. Why aren't you out there watching your fucking kid? I don't know. Look, I'm not here to tell anybody how to parent their kid. But anyway, so he tells me, the little kid from next door is like, you should let him play. And I said, and I looked right at this little kid, you know, 4 years old, and said, you should shut the fuck up. That's what I mean by I'm a terrible parent. Because that kid looked at me like, he couldn't believe what I just said to him. Like, how dare you? Don't you know who I am? And look, before you go crazy on me in the comments, yeah, I know that was not the right thing to say. My wife is dealing with me on that, okay? Fucking snitches. Anyway, look, I know that wasn't the right thing to say, but I pop fly. That's why I say I'm not a good parent. I'm not a good parent to the neighborhood. Like, you know, the old saying that it takes a village. I'm not the villager that you want to take notes from, okay? Look, I admit it. I'm working on it. I just get mad sometimes, you know, because these little fuckers gang up on me. I know they're just kids and they want to have fun, but, you know, when I was a kid, like I said, I'm old school. If someone said it's time to go, it's time to go. I mean, it wasn't like we just got out there or he just got out there. The kid's been playing for over an hour. Let's go. You know, the sun's going down. It's time to come inside. We got to go eat. We got to, you know, end our night. So that was one incident. And then there was another one where there was like three of them. You know, there's a little park. We live in government housing. There's a little tot lot everywhere because if there's one thing that service members like to do, it's make babies. So there's tot lots all over our community. So we're over there. There's some swings and a little jungle gym and a slide. So, you know, and there's like five of them, which is great for me because there's more kids. That means my son doesn't want to drag me around and, you know, because he wants to, you know, run in the mud and get sandy and dirty and stuff like that. I'm like, eh, I'm not really with that. So, you know, but there's a lot of kids here today. So they're playing together and having a good time. So what ends up happening is same thing. You know, it's I try to stretch it as long as possible because if he gets it all out of his system, he's going to go home, eat dinner, pass out. That means me and mommy can hang out. So that's awesome. So they're out there playing. There's like five of them, including my kid. So everybody's, and what's great about that is if you're a parent and you're out there with your kids and there's other kids, you guys can sync up and you guys can take it to them, you know, together. You guys can gang up on them. You guys can say, hey, what time is it? Oh, is it 6 o'clock? Oh, okay, at 6:30 we're going in. Hey, that sounds good. Yeah, at 6:30 I'm gonna take mine in too. Oh yeah, oh, are we doing 6:30? Okay, yeah, 6:30, that's 30 minutes away. Sounds good. So we all gang up on the kids, all the parents gang up on the kids together and say, yeah, we're gonna go in 6:30, we're putting the hammer down, everyone comes in. Now why does everybody go in at 6:30? All the parents say, all right, ding ding, 6:30, time to go in, and all the kids get mad at me. The kids get mad that they turn to me like, oh, why do we have to go in? I'm like, don't talk to me. Talk to your dad. Talk to your mom. I don't know. You're not mine. That one belongs to me. And these two, like, because, you know, they weren't all playing together. They were all just playing at the same little park. But like three of them were all playing together. And one of them was my kid. So they all come to me and he's like, can Orion come out tomorrow? Like, his name is Orion. I didn't mention that before. But his name is Orion. Can Orion come out tomorrow? I said, yeah, maybe tomorrow. Yeah, okay. And then this little kid looks right at me and says, you always say that. And I'm like, so? Maybe we will come out tomorrow. Maybe we won't. I can't see the future. And he says, huh, whatever. And I'm just like, And I'm trying to think because, you know, I mean, I've been the crazy guy in the community before, and I try not to do that because it just makes more tension, you know? So I'm like, well, you know what? So I just say something that I feel like an adult would say to a kid who was mouthing off to him. I said, why don't you go home and have your dad teach you some manners? That's all I said. I said it just like that. I said, why don't you go home and have your dad teach you some manners? And he said, why don't you go home and I forget what exactly he said, but it was something, but he had that retaliatory tone. He said, why don't you go home and, you know, something, something, blah, blah, blah. And I said, why don't you go fuck yourself? And I said it in front, ugh, I can't get that one back. And I know. It was a kid and he was like maybe 60, 70 feet down the block running back, and he was mouthing off to me, and I got mad, and I shouldn't have said that. I know I shouldn't have said that. I know. I'm a shitty parent. I'm a good dad, but I'm a shitty parent, okay? I couldn't come up with stuff fast enough, so I cussed the kid out, and that's I mean, I'm not sorry because, you know, that little fucker should have kept his mouth shut, but anyway, that's beside the point. So the dad guilt, man. And I felt bad about it. That's another aspect of the dad guilt. You know, I felt bad afterwards because I shouldn't have said that. And I felt like, oh, shit. Because the last thing you want is some parent knocking on your door and saying, hey, did you say XYZ to my kid? This better be good this time. Anyway, listen, man. If you're a parent, you know how hard this is already. Don't be like me. Just rise above it, walk away. It's the same problem I have with adults. I can't rise above it. I get mad, and I got to get that last word in because I'm right and everybody else is wrong. You know what? That's the kind of stuff that, you know, just makes you a joyless person, you know, because, you know, this all that's doing is taking away from you, you know. So don't be like me. Keep it chill. Enjoy your family. Enjoy the trifecta if you have one, if you're lucky enough to have one. If you have a wife who is going to shower you with presents when the trifecta hits, you know, enjoy it.